everything, and he runs the affairs of all things. This is a matter settled within people's nature. No one disputes about it, whether he is a Muslim or a kafir. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said concerning the kuffar in Surah Luqman 25, وَلَئِنْ سَأَلْتَهُمْ مَنْ خَلَقَ السَّمَوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ وَسَخَّرَ الشَّمْسَ وَالْقَمَرَ لَيَقُولُنَّ اللَّهُ. And if you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ask them, who has created the heavens and the earth? They, the mushriks, will certainly say Allah. Say, all praises and thanks be to Allah, but most of them know not. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asserted in Surah Yusuf in 12:106, وَمَا يُؤْمِنُ أَكْثَرُهُمْ بِاللَّهِ إِلَّا وَهُمْ مُشْرِكُونَ. And most of them believe not in Allah except that they attribute partners unto Him. Mujahid, the scholar of Tafsir, rahimahullah, said about most of them belief, that their belief here means that Allah is our creator and He is the one who provides for us and He is the one who causes us to die. This is iman, this is faith with shirk. Why? Because they attributed partners unto Him. The mushriks did not believe that their gods are associates of Allah in lordship in the creation. They believed that this was to Allah alone, and that their gods are means of nearness, bringing them closer to Allah and taken as intercessors with Allah. This is clearly said in the Quran when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stated about them in Surah Az-Zumar 39:3. أَلَا لِلَّهِ الدِّينُ الْخَالِصُ وَالَّذِينَ اتَّخَذُوا مِن دُونِهِ أَوْلِيَاءَ مَا نَعْبُدُهُمْ إِلَّا لِيُقَرِّبُونَا إِلَى اللَّهِ زُلْفَى. Surely the religion is for Allah alone, the pure religion. And those who take as protectors and helpers besides Him, they say, we worship them only that they may bring us near to Allah. And in Surah Fatir, verse 40, قال الله تعالى قل أرأيتم شركاءكم قل أرأيتم شركاءكم الذين تدعون من دون الله أروني ماذا خلقوا من الأرض أم لهم شرك في السماوات أم آتيناهم كتابا فهم على بينة منه بل إن يعد الظالمون بعضهم بعضا إلا غرورا. سورة فاطر. verse 40. Say, O Muhammad, tell me or inform me, what do you think about your so-called partners with God or partner gods to whom you call upon besides Allah? Show me what they have created of the earth. Show me what they have created of the earth. Or have they share any share in the heavens? Or have we given them a book so that they act on clear proofs therefrom? Nay, but they promise one another nothing but delusions, those polytheists and wrongdoers. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke about the mushriks of Quraysh in Surah As-Saffat, verse 36. إنهم كانوا إذا قيل لهم لا إله إلا الله يستكبرون. ويقولون أئنا لتاركو آلهتنا لشاعر مجنون. Truly, when it was said to them, لا إله إلا الله, none has the right to be worshipped but Allah, they puffed themselves up with pride. They denied it. And they said, are we going to abandon our gods for the sake of a mad poet? And Allah spoke about them saying in Surah Sad 38, verse 5, أَجَعَلَ الْآلِهَةَ إِلَهًا وَاحِدًا إِنَّ هَذَا لَشَيْءٌ عُجَابٌ. Has he made the Aliha, the gods, into one god, Allah? Verily, this is a curious thing. Nevertheless, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala affirmed this tawheed of lordship and asserted it for a purpose, in order that it be a denotion, a proof that He, Allah, is the only true God who deserves to be worshipped alone, meaning to prove